dimensions of consciousness into our awareness. The key to growth is the introduction of higher dimensions, of a world of consciousness that we must now absorb into our awareness. I want to push this a little further, to say that critical our maturity, our growth, especially the spiritual, is all that the Gospels introduce us to pertaining to Christ, so that we might know that Jesus Christ is Lord, and by knowing Him, we might believe Him and have life in His name. That is the kind of higher dimension of consciousness that human beings like you and I must allow to become a part of our awareness. As one who serves the public, part and parcel of my function is to, when it is necessary, to introduce or present a character by way of character reference to the other, so that the one who will meet the one who is being referred, that one may know all that is said about the other, and knowing that person will get a better understanding of the truth with that person. Are you with me? I must speak only of what I know pertaining to one that I'm asked to make reference to. 2018 is a new, and it is one that welcomes varying expressions. Still, we are introduced to this new year, and one in which we will be exposed to more alarming experiences. Already. The year has introduced us to the ugly and the wicked, the intent of humanity. While this is a soul, friends, this new year, no doubt, is a gift from God to all of us as human beings. The year that reveals to us the faith of God, and the fact that God is and will remain God in this year. It also allows us to understand that being a receipt of this new year from a faithful God, we must become faithful agents. Faithful agents who will respond to what we are in receipt of and promote faithfully all that we are in receipt of. What I want us to understand further is that the Gospel of John introduces all of us to the incarnate Christ who exists as the Word. Here is Jesus being revealed introduced to the world a world of darkness, a world of dread, a world in violence, a world where diabolic acts and actors. What a world. But what a world. What a world. The word of God is being introduced and revealed. Today I rise to reintroduce you to Jesus Christ, the Word, the Logos, who was introduced to this wretched world years before us, and the Word that we have come to know and trust wore out of this wretched world. And to this time in our history, friends, a history of darkness, a history which we find the world being pregnant, laden with dark deeds, occasioned by the people of God. Here is presented to us the greatest transforming and liberating presence of all times. I introduce to you and reintroduce to you Jesus Christ, the Word of God. I give you that pleasure. Though it is an awesome responsibility, I take you that pleasure that I'm filled with gospel to present this, the Word of God, Jesus Christ, to all of us. As we call through the first chapter of John, as our eyes and minds are focused on the first 5 verses of this of the Gospel of John, the evangelist John seeks to introduce the Word to the world. And what a way to introduce us in 2018 to the Word of God, which is very important to life and faith. As I come through this, on this first Sunday of this new year, I seek to make a simple but profound delivery of this basic truth that we find in John the Evangelist, once called the Maverick of all times. What do we find in this? These introductory statements of John on this the first Sunday of 2018. At close to 25 minutes after 11. What? Friends, John introduced us, and I seek to reintroduce us to Jesus, the Word, who reigns constantly as sovereign. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. If anybody tells you that God in Jesus Christ is not eternal, tell them to let them lie. Jesus, the Word, reigns supremely, constantly, eternally. ons nog een keer.
With the understanding that we will not last. The word of God reigns constantly. The logos, the truth, the logics, the reasons of faith and me allow us to understand that God in Jesus Christ, the word, remains constant, eternal, Alpha and Omega, beginning and the end. We, in contrast, are temporary. We will not last. Our life existence is transient. Last week, as I took a taxi, I heard an old lady in the front. She seems to be a TVJ. She knows everything. Master, you know, you didn't know. A fighter. Me want to see her after the first week because realize how much gone on. 25? Much? A lot. A lot. The diabolic acts of the people of God stand in contrast to the goodness and the benevolence of God, who is constant. There are some truths, other truths about us as human beings who are unlike the eternal constant God. We to some extent at randomly scattershot approach to life. We're not constant. We're not consistent. Our lives are not hungry to the constant eternal God. Oh, yes, many of us, we are so fickle and faithless and frail, and we bring this to God. There is need in light of our understanding of the eternal, constant God that we should never seek to exalt ourselves. Understand that God, who is eternal, must be trusted. Must be trusted, must be believed upon. With all our means, let us take a different approach in 2018 to understand that we who are temporal and temporary, we are randomly and fickle and faithless, must recognize the constancy and the eternal presence of the immutable God. In the army, in the gone away, is always there. Not only do I unearth from the introductory statements of these of truth, but I want us to understand further that aside from the fact that Jesus Christ, the Word, the Logos, the Word, remains constant, eternal, last suffering, when we go further down into verse 2 and 3, we recognize that Jesus, the Word, in the second instance, is the cause for creation. He's the cause. He's the cause. The question put us on has to be asked, and is asked of us in 2018, even now, what do you think about Jesus? The answer comes back. And hear it from us. He is all right. There is nothing unquestionable about Jesus Christ. Oh, maybe I should say there's nothing questionable about Jesus Christ. Everything that we can present to Jesus about Jesus will baffle us. Jesus is the one upon whom the great works of creation rest. Hear what John says to us as he introduced us to him. All of us, in capital, all the things were made by him. All the things came to be by him. And without him, nothing was made that has been made, including you and me. Isn't that the logic? All things
you know, when I thought about it, even the cockroach that I killed. But I would love to see. Even the broken lizard that creates a bother for us at home. All things were made by him. He's a call for creation.
And when human beings like you and I say that human beings are the crown jewel of God's creation, what do we say about those things that were made before us? And how do we treat with creation and how to respond to Jesus, the Word, who remains the cause of creation?
All things were made by Him. I am made by Him, therefore I am because of Christ.
Because He's the cause. When I wake up to worship God, nothing will stop that. Because God, Jesus Christ, the cause for my existence. When I come in the space to worship God, I realize that all things, including myself, that has been made by God, seek to give God honor and glory. I'm frightened by what the gospel said, that if we fail to praise God, He will raise up sticks and stones. If all things have been made by God, God can make all things to praise Him. What's up with heaven? Do we know that the trees, even now, are praising Him? Look at the wall.
Things visible and invisible, well, thrones or dominions or rulers.